My father made the film here. Look here, the drawing he made.
A ring in a ring in a ring.
Do you see that arrow? Something must be hidden there. But what? And where?
Aha!
Ha!
What the...
You noticed our wall painting. Its name is Ring-a-Ding-Ding, which means infinity. It's been drawn by the famous painter Cavernosa Canasostri 200 years ago.
But my father painted it.
Cavernosa Canasostri was your father?
You just made that name up.
What is it illustrating?
In my opinion, it sort of looks like the rings in the wind chapel, but I'm no art connoisseur.
Wind chapel?
And what kind of place is this here?
Glad you asked. Hello and welcome to the halls of the Dynasty. There you go, your guest passes and one soft cookie each.
Thanks.
On behalf of our team, we wish you a pleasant visit.
That cookie was delicious and really soft.
Keep track of your luggage, don't take pictures, no phosphos, no loud breathing, don't touch anything. Parents are liable for their children. Thank you.
No loud breathing? Okay. Have you had problems with loud breathing? Like, seriously, who even breathes that loudly? So, what the heck is this place? Some pins.
We have to find the place with these rings. Whatever Reminepo hid in there, he wanted us to find it. I will just leave it hanging up. It looks great here.
Yes, it does. Looks like there's an eye pointing here. Some pins.
So many pins. Reminepo apparently wanted to make sure that his work would stay up there. No one would notice if a few are missing.
He keeps looking at himself in the mirror. Oh, there's a brick. I can push it out.
I can't do anything from here. I can't do anything from here.
Wait, what? You can't? Why?
That brick looks loose. I won't be able to move the brick with my bare hands. I can't do anything for... I wonder how I can get up there.
And what's more is, why would I want to? What's the point of getting up there? I mean, it's just going to take me inside, right? Which is where I'm at now.
A phosphos. It's floating peacefully.
Oh, that's a different location. Inner courtyard. Hold on, let me go back. Wow, this place is really big.
A mirror. Pretty mirror. Can I?
Don't touch it!
Ah, okay. He seems to be obsessed with his mirror. Baking book. What does that say on it? Cookies? Cookies.
What book is that? Baking for Posers by Gordon Rumsay. Maybe I can impress Laura with it.
Gordon Rumsay. I can't imagine who that's referring to. No.
The soft cookie recipe. A handful of sugar, half a cup of nectarine juice, a kilo of flour, and a portion of chocolate flakes.
Seriously? That's it? What about, like, baking soda and baking powder and salt? I think you're kind of missing some key ingredients there.
For top-class soft cookies, you'll need a handful of sugar, half a cup of nectarine juice, a kilo of flour, and a portion of chocolate flakes.
It also doesn't seem to have any fat, like butter, margarine, oil, even? I don't think nectarine juice has any fat. That's an alcoholic drink, isn't it? I'm suspicious of this recipe. I do not think that would actually make very good cookies. But anyway, it doesn't matter. Alright, I can see behind him looks like there's a mixing bowl, so I'm guessing I'm gonna need to get him to leave to make the cookies. But I don't think there's any point in doing that yet, because at the moment I don't even know what I need the cookies for. So let's just take things one step at a time, just look at the environment, see what I've got.
A key. It seems to be important.
Oh, surely he wouldn't mind if I just took it right in front of him, right?
Don't even think about it, boy!
Maybe I will just leave it there.
I was just looking, jeez. Fire beetles, whoa.
Fire beetles. There were a lot of these in Conroy's kitchen. Hello, you fire beetles.
Leave them alone! They're cooling off!
Wait, are they? Oh, they're used as a source of heat. That is so cool.
An empty cold oven. Cool oven. Can I?
Don't touch it!
Okay, yeah, so I can't do anything here while he's here, so gonna need to get him to leave at some point, but not yet. Ooh, a tassel.
A tassel? Very well. Now I can decorate. As long as the guy doesn't look over here.
Yoink. Alright, I think that's it for everything in here. Yeah, alright. Into the inner courtyard. The little icon for that phosphos there is so cute.
Poor Asposians. I wonder what they thought of in their last moment. That shield is extremely rusty. Someone should really clean up around here. I can't take it with me. It's too rusted.
Wait, like it's rusted to the wall? Nectarine bed. Ooh, well it just so happens I need nectarine juice.
Ah, oh, a bed of nectarines. They say you can see yourself in their juice. I don't know if it's just a metaphor or if it's true. Steve won't notice if some are missing. He hasn't even noticed yet that he's been talking to himself for decades.
Yeah, he doesn't seem to be very observant.
Recipe for soft cookies. A handful of sugar, half a kilo of flour.
Alright, but how do I turn them into juice?
A bunch of nectarines. You can tell that the juice is fresh if the surface is smooth like glass. No, I'm not thirsty.
Maybe I don't even need to turn it into juice. Maybe I can just use them directly in the bowl, like squeeze it out or something, I don't know.
I can't use that.
Well, you could tickle Laura with it. Tickle, tickle!
Well, I could, but I...
Oh, fine, oh, fine. What is that? Jump rope? Why is there a jump rope in the courtyard? Somebody played jump rope here 20 years ago, and it's been sitting there ever since.
Looks like a jump rope. I don't want to play right now.
Wait a minute, can I play? Oh, you can play you can play your nose at any time you want. Okay, yeah, it's not very responsive. You can't really play music with it too much. Oh, that sounded horrible. Ooh. That didn't sound bad. Mushrooms.
Put these mushrooms in your ears, and you're practically deaf.
They do actually look just like earplugs, don't they? Yeah, look at that. But it's a very convenient shape.
Put these mushrooms in your ears.
But what could I use them for? Dynasty ruin.
These ruins look impressive. How beautiful it must have been here.
Hey, look at all these. Just look at the forest. It's beautiful. You have these buildings just like, looks like they've been partially taken over by the forest. They really stand out amongst all the trees and roots and whatever this stuff is.
A golden carpet. This strange family was obviously rich enough to trample on their money.
Yeah, pretty much. Well, okay, what the heck am I gonna do with this stuff? Big door. Something tells me it's not going to open.
A magnificent door. It most likely leads to a magnificent place. Anything else would be disappointing.
I agree. Surely it doesn't just lead to like a bathroom or something, right?
It's locked. And Steve has a key sitting on his counter.
Okay, time to get to work. Look at that little Fosfos. So I have a bunch of stuff, but again, what do I do with it? I need to distract him or get him out of here or something. Let's just talk to him.
Do you have any questions?
Yes. What are you doing here?
I manage the reception.
Oh, please.
Laura.
But that guy is totally insane.
I am not insane, thank you very much. Should you have any complaints, I can refer you to my boss.
Fine. I would like to speak with your boss.
Laura, don't make a scene.
You have a complaint about my colleague. What's that lazy, good-for-nothing idiot done now?
Wow.
Okay. Yep, he's gone off. Gone into the, My brain just failed there. Gone off his rocker? There we go, that one works. I was gonna say gone off the deep end, gone into the deep end, and now I forgot what the phrase even is. Gone deep, something about deep and end and gone, I don't even know anymore. Anyway, yes. He has multiple personalities.
So, you're the boss here?
Excuse me, I haven't been working 25 years at the reception just to be the boss here.
Sorry.
Oh, no, you don't have to apologize.
What do you need a receptionist for?
Well, I'm a relic, so to speak, of former times. Steve joined us after the attack when the dynasty was already gone.
What dynasty?
Every time I think of it, I remember the song. It starts like that. Calm down, Steve. I've forgotten the rest anyway.
I hate that song!
What the hell just happened? Okay, well, I have a feeling I know what I need to do. I think I need to use my nose flute again to piss him off. But before that, let's keep talking to him.
So, you were here before, Steve?
Yes, I was born and raised here. My dad was head of the reception, as was his father before him.
And his father?
Him too.
And his father?
Yes, he as well.
And his father?
How long do you want to keep doing this?
I don't mind it. I like to talk about my family.
Do you? Well, okay. Tell me more, Pete.
How long have you known each other?
Let me think about...
14 years.
I was about to say that!
How did you meet?
One morning, I got up, and he was there!
Oh, really? Almost like he was there the whole time. Because he's you. Tell me about these soft cookies.
Great cookies. Do you like baking?
Thanks! Yes! It's my hobby! You know, the baking, it's important that...
Please don't.
That you use the right amounts. The last batch I made...
Can't we just...
Were these original soft cookies you've just ate in this top-class oven?
They tasted great.
How kind of you to say that!
Are you two done? Good. Back to the subject. We have to...
How did you get the cookies to turn out so fluffy and soft?
The secret is the ingredients, hmm? The softer the ingredients, the softer the cookies.
Okay, enough. The apocalypse is coming. Your cookies can wait.
But not for too long.
Yeah, or they'll burn.
Okay, the softer the ingredients, the softer the cookies. I don't think it works like that. Anyway, what do you mean soft ingredients? Like, how do you have soft flour? What? Does that just mean you grind it finer? What? I don't get it. Tell me more. Tell me more about your soft cookies.
Again, about the cookies.
Robert, stop.
But...
No, I mean it. You can have cookies once we've saved the world.
Oh, all right.
But I want to have cookies before I save the world.
Regarding the guest passes, what exactly can we do with them?
Well, what would you like to do with them?
Can we use them to have a look at the runes?
No, sorry. They only allow you to see the courtyard.
But then why did you ask us what...
A guest pass only permits access to the inner courtyard, according to the regulations.
And who came up with these stupid regulations?
I did!
How can we get into the Wind Chapel?
Only with golden passes.
Oh, okay. And where can we get those?
You don't get them. You just have them.
I see. And who, has such a golden pass?
The family.
What family?
The family that used to live here.
The petrified Asposians?
No! The family is still alive! They'll return any moment!
Okay, quiet. No sudden movements.
Golden passes. Well, it just so happens I have a golden carpet, although I'm not exactly sure how that's going to play into it, but it pretty obviously has a connection. Any chance of a courtyard guided tour?
Can you show us the inner courtyard?
Do you have a guest pass?
What? You just gave us these stupid passes.
Yes, we do.
My pleasure, then.
Please follow me.
How many voices does he have? That's the third one at this point. Okay. So I need to get inside and leave him here. How would I do that? I could tickle him with a tassel.
No, thank you. I'm not allowed to accept gifts from guests.
I could stick some pins in his eye. No. I wonder if I can point out to him that the shield's extremely rusted. Do you think he'd get maybe obsessive and start to clean it?
How long has the door been locked?
Since right before I started working here.
And you've never opened it before?
No! No one has ever come with a golden pass!
Has anyone ever come here at all?
Yes! But that was before my time. Pete told me that it used to be busy when the family was still alive.
Oh, well, if Pete told you, then it must be true. Tell me about Pete again.
Where's Pete?
I assume he's managing the reception in my absence.
Good, because visitors could show up any moment.
Could you ask Pete to come here?
But why? We're talking so peacefully, and his presence only means things will get loud again!
Jesus! Calm down! Calm down. There's nothing to be worried about. Tell me about that door.
Looks sturdy.
Yes, doesn't it? This door was built by Stella the Sturdy, as well as that window back there.
But there is no window.
There used to be one, until it fell out.
Okay.
What did this place used to be?
What do you mean by used to be? This has always been the inner courtyard of the Wind Chapel.
It's nice here.
Yes, but difficult to heat properly.
I guess... You do have a bit of an insulation problem, actually. Because you have no roof. Other than that, though, I think the heat should stay in pretty well.
Are you in here often?
No. It makes me sad every time I come here.
Why?
I don't know.
All right, maybe I can bring his attention to the shield.
I can't take it with me. It's too rusted. That shield is extremely rusty. Someone should really clean up around here.
I mean, look, Robert's totally hinting at it. Someone should really clean up around here, and he's specifically mentioning that it's really rusty. There's got to be something I do with it. But how? I don't know. Let me just see if I can go back inside, and let's see if he stays out here.
Ah! You want to go back?
Follow me. No. Alright, well, I can grab this rolling pin.
Definitely a rolling pin. I used to work in Conroy's kitchen, and I recognize a rolling pin when I see it.
Yes, I've seen many rolling pin in my day, too.
Wow, it's heavy. The perfect balance of kitchen utensil and weapon.
Maybe I could use that to hit the shield? Give me a door again.
Do you have it?
Oh, actually, right, there's the song and the Golden Pass. Let's talk about the Golden Pass.
About the Golden Pass. We can go into the Wind Chapel with one.
Exactly!
And if we just walk in anyway?
I'm the only one with the secret key that opens the door to the hall.
Do you mean the one in front of you on the counter?
Yes, it even says so on the box. Secret.
I can't let you in without golden passes. Do you have golden passes?
No.
Then I can't let you in.
So, if we had these golden passes...
Oh, so you have the golden passes.
Yes.
But Laura, that isn't true.
Shh. May I see the passes?
I forgot them at home.
Then how can I know if...
Okay, we lied. We're sorry. We just wanted to go into the chapel. I'm so sorry.
Wow, you really are honest, huh?
Admission denied!
But we really have them?
Not true! You have to keep out!
It's gotta be something to do with the golden rug. I can keep talking about the golden passes. Wow, okay, let's see what happens.
Can't we just see the Wind Chapel without the golden passes?
If I make an exception for you, I'll have to make one for everybody!
For who? There's no one here.
Someone could show up at any moment!
I don't think there's much chance of a slippery slope situation here, because there's no one else to slip on the slope.
What song is that?
Oh, it's so old. I've almost forgotten it over the years. I only remember the beginning of it.
He's gonna play it again, isn't he?
Singing is forbidden!
Oh, Steve, you old party pooper. I forgot the rest anyway. Hey, boy, I'd probably remember the rest if I could get out of here.
Get out of here? But how could I...
No idea, but I have to get some fresh air. I've been stuck in this bakehouse for 14 years.
15.
All right, let me see if I can play that song.
Thanks for the information.
Well, that's what I'm here for.
I still don't know why I would want to get him out of here. Because as far as I know, the only thing that's going to allow me to do is make cookies. Or bake... Yeah, bake cookies. But why would I want to bake cookies? I don't know. But let's try it anyway. All right, let's see if I can remember the pitches.
Quiet!
Okay, that didn't work. Come on. When he's looking away...
Stop it!
Okay, I'll be really careful this time. Really careful.
Stop it! I can't bear this!
Oh, you can't. Okay.
Quiet! Stop it! Stop it! Quiet!
Okay, it's not going to work. I'm not exactly sure what to do. Like, I have a lot of possible connections here, right? Like, I need to play the song to annoy him to make something happen. I need to get him out of here to bake cookies, but I don't know why. This golden carpet is obviously connected to the, the golden passes somehow. These mushrooms are probably connected to the music somehow. I can't put it all together yet.
No thanks. I'm not allowed to accept gifts from guests.
What would I use the mushrooms for? I mean, obviously it's to stop, to put in someone's ears, but if I can't put them in his ears, then whose ears am I going to put them in? My own?
I don't want to clog my ears.
Yeah, what am I going to use them for?
I don't know what I'm supposed to do with that.
I wonder if I need to, like, cut it up. Into pass-like shapes. But I don't have anything I could cut.
No thanks, I'm not a...
Alright, let's go back outside.
Do you have any questions?
Can you show...
Do you... What?
Yep.
Please!
Alright, let me try banging on this thing, see if that does it.
Should I roll the rust flat? What would that do?
Roll the rust flat? Isn't the rust already kind of flat? I don't know, he said it would work as a weapon, right?
I don't know what I'm supposed to do with that. Definitely a rolling pin. I used to work in Conroy's kitchen, and I know a rolling pin when I see one.
Yeah, there's gotta be like one step that I'm missing in this, right? Like, I just need to get the ball rolling and then everything is gonna fall into place.
No, thank you, I
can't give him anything.
What? Nothing to say.
What if I make a noise out here?
Quiet!
Again.
Quiet!
Okay, let's not do that.
Hey, Laura.
Maybe I can get her... Oh, okay, here we go.
Are you okay?
Well, I have no idea where my dad is. I'm cold, I'm hungry, and the people here are all crazy. But other than that, I'm good. Thanks.
No problem.
What's your favorite color?
Red.
Keep talking. And.
Have you always lived under the Makata?
Well, my dad hid me with the help of the Makata's owner. I started to rebel at an early age.
Against your foster father?
Against Conroy. When I was 8 years old, I carried out my first attack on the palace.
What? When you were 8, you made an attack? Damn.
Where did you learn to fight?
Like everybody else, in the schoolyard.
Nice coat. Goes well with, your personality.
Thanks. Nice nose. Goes well with your shoes.
Thank you. God, Robert's adorable.
Did you see how the gate opened when I was playing my nose earlier?
Yes, that was great. But I can do the same thing with a crowbar and some dynamite.
Yes, but my flute nose is much quieter, and less dangerous and less expensive, and it doesn't kill anything or anyone.
I didn't know that I can open doors with my nose.
I've never seen anything like that before.
Impressed?
You're really something special, flute nose.
Aww.
These people all have noses like mine.
I've never seen such Asposians before. I wonder what they did to Conroy that made him send the bazillions after them.
Do you think I belong here?
You'd at least have a lot of space to yourself here.
I've got a strange feeling about these petrified Asposians.
I think that's because you're one of them.
But what does that mean?
That means that Conroy owes you much more than you'll probably ever know.
What a strange place. All of a sudden, it seems as though time is standing still.
Yes, I know what you mean. I wonder what has happened to my father.
Don't worry, we'll find him. This place seems familiar to me.
That can't be. The gate hasn't been open for years.
So I guess I probably grew up around here.
Laura?
Yep?
Is it possible that this Steve is a little... well...
a little completely nuts?
You think so?
Robert, we have to watch our step around him.
Wouldn't surprise me if he just decides to randomly stab us in the back. No, he wouldn't do that. Alright, can you distract him?
Laura, I would like to look around the ruins. Can you distract Steve? I mean, Pete. Whoever.
Fine. I'll try. Hello? Can I talk to you?
Ah! It's about cookies, right?
Well, actually...
the history of the cookie is one full of misunderstandings. For example...
Thanks. That's enough. Sorry, I can't do it. I wanted to kill him after only two words.
Oh, seriously? Come on, Laura. Okay, let's just knock him out.
No, thank you. I'm not allowed to accept gifts from guests.
Okay, Laura, can you knock him out?
Why should I do that?
Let me take one last look at my stuff, and I might... but I'm probably gonna have to use a hint. Just look at my stuff. Pins, okay. Baking book for recipe. The bouquet of nautarines is for the recipe, which I can't do until I can get into the kitchen when he's not there. A tassel? No freaking clue what to do with that.
A tassel? Good. Now I can decorate.
Decorate what? The shield!
I can't scrape off rust with the tassel. It would be like trying to stop Laura with a ball of yarn.
Yeah, it wouldn't work.
I don't think that will...
yeah, that didn't make any sense. Okay. Jump rope. Use the jump rope on the petrified Asposians. If this doesn't work, nothing will.
That's just a run.
Okay, hint time. I just need something to get the ball rolling. Find out about the secret of the Wind Chapel. Let's not do that yet. Get golden passes to be able to take a guided tour in the Wind Chapel. Help Pete to remember the entire song. How would I do that? He said if he could get out of there, he could remember the entire song, right? How would I get him out of there? Oh! The shield! I need to polish it to a mirror shine so that Pete can be out here, right? Yeah, okay, how do I do that?
The shield would only become rustier.
Okay, Okay, I know what I need to do for that part, but how do I do it? Nothing I have would really work. I need something that can scrape off rust. Yeah, none of this is gonna work. Right? No. What's that?
Well, I could.
No. Okay, so I'm missing something, I think. Alright, I just need a little bit more... Yeah, let's get some more hints for the rust thing, okay? Pete is the reflection of Steve, yes. Uh-huh. But he doesn't remember, the song will come in handy eventually. Three parts. Mm-hmm. You have to go to the inner courtyard with him and ask him about the song. There's no mirror in the inner courtyard yet, where Pete could be mirrored. Yep, I know. Steve could work as a near Steve, that could work as a mirror. Yes, there is, but I need to get the rust off of it. But it's very rusty. Yes. You need something to remove the rust. Yes. You can find something behind Steve's counter. Okay, so I need to get Steve away from there first. And to do that, I need... What? Okay, I need to figure out how to get Steve away from the counter. How could I do that? Hold on.
Ah! You want to go-
Let me go back outside. Hmm, there's nothing quite like the taste of cold tea. Delicious! Hmm. Oh yeah! Okay, so I don't know if I can do something with the bricks yet, but... We have the color dust, which could be used to color the passes.
Hmm, they left. Seem to be afraid of me.
Alright, so how would I do this? How would I do this? I need to color them, okay. So I need to get them beneath the color moths.
Not possible.
And...
Yes, their stupid dust sticks to everything.
I just kind of broke the game, but thankfully it came back.
Color moths. They try to hide themselves in a fog of dust that matches their surroundings.
I hate them. They dye everything.
What don't you hate?
If people, animals, and objects were nicer to me, I would hate them less.
Oh, but I'm nice to you. Do you hate me? Okay, it matches their surroundings, so that's what the golden carpet is for. Hang it from the branch. Okay, now where do I put the guest passes? Here?
I can't do that.
I can't just, like, put them on the ground, can I? I don't know, let's just scare them over there. Let's see what happens. Give me.
Not possible.
There we go, gold dust. Now what?
They always leave immediately.
Yeah. So... So what?
Why should I do that?
I don't know. Okay, well, I think about that. Let's try to get this brick out. Do I have anything that could work? I don't think pins are gonna work.
I can't do
that. No. Actually, I don't think anything I have is gonna work.
I can't knock it in any
further. No. Okay, wait, so maybe I don't need to move it out, but I need to move the others in? So, let me, Wait, actually, no, get back up. Can I reach this?
I can't do anything from here.
No. Can I knock these in at all? Yes, I can, okay. But how do I get that one?
I can't do anything from here.
Can I get up on the branch?
I won't take the carpet with me again.
No, I don't want to take the carpet. Laura, can you reach it?
That could be fun. Won't help, though.
I don't know. Alright, let's see what that did. Like, once I get them all in, what is that going to actually do?
That brick's sticking out.
Oh. Okay, I see. But then once I can get to the top, what is that?
I won't be able to move the brick with my... That brick looks loose.
Alright, so I need to do that to get to the top, but why?
I wonder how I can get up there.
Why would you want to? Alright, I'm pretty sure I have everything to color the passes, right? Probably. I don't know, I need another hint again. Or do I? I don't see why I can't just put the passes on the ground and have the dust just fall in it or something. Do I need something to collect it? Or what? Let's play a song! Wait a minute, did it actually do something? It made the phosphos react. That's really cool. If you look at it, like one of its little, I don't know what you call it, one of its little bits that's hanging off. If I press the first note, which is the number one, it's the one all the way on the left. And then now number two, the one over. That's really cool. Look at that phosphos, it's so happy. It loves the music. Alright, would that actually help, though? Let me scare him back over.
Not pot.
Okay, that did absolutely nothing.
They always leave immediately.
Okay, another hint time. Need something to polish it. Should I go down that one? Let's go with the golden passes. Make them, yes. Yep. Turn the guest passes into golden passes, yep. Yes, I have seen the colored moths. They secrete dust. That can be useful for coloring things, yes. Changes its position, it's either on the left near the golden carpet or on the right near the bushes, yep. When the color moths are near the golden carpet on the left, they secrete golden dust, I know. With a golden dust, you could color the guest passes. I know. They prefer to stay among each other, and they don't let Robert come closer. I know. With the help of an artificial color moth, you can get the guest passes in touch with the color moths. Artificial color moth? Oh. Like... this? Aha! Okay. Is that it, or do I need more parts?
What am I trying to do here?
Oh, I know exactly what I'm trying to do here. No, they need wings. What could I use for wings?
Why should I do that?
Do I have anything that would work for wings?
That could be fun. Won't help, though.
Maybe it's good enough. Oh, those are the wings. Is that really convincing enough? Okay. If you say so.
Not possible. That could be fun. Won't help, though.
Wait, what? Is it not complete?
What am I trying to do here?
No, it's not complete. What am I missing? It doesn't look like I'm missing anything. It looks pretty much like it. It's got the wings and it's got the antenna. And it's got the body.
I can't. I don't.
Okay, let's go back to that. It really looks like a color moth, but how could you get it in touch with the color moths without scaring them away? Wait a minute. Connected to this? Ah. See, I really like the hint system. Okay, but I need to be... That's why I need to stand up there, right? I need to get up there so I can hang it down.
They always leave immediately.
Yeah. Okay, so now how do I get the brick? To be pushed in. I can't reach it. Oh. Well, I guess that's kind of obvious, isn't it? Never mind. You push them in from here. Alright, that should do. Yeah, this hint system is really, really nice. They don't spoil the entire puzzle, or at least they don't necessarily do. And they... Because usually when you need help with a puzzle, like you've seen here, I just need a little bit of a hint. And then it puts me, down a certain direction. And then a lot of things just fall into place. It's very nice. No, don't get all the way off. Okay, scare them back over.
Not possible.
Get up on the wall. And here we go.
That's just a random...
No. Okay, I guess I gotta get up. Okay.
Now I have golden passes. Golden passes. Take care, Frankenmoth. You were a good friend.
I'll always remember you, Frankenmoth. Go be with your people. Okay, about those golden passes.
We would like to see the Wind Chapel.
Do you have a golden ticket?
Oh, yes.
Please follow me.
Look at all the petrified Asposians. Isn't that sad?
By petrified Asposians, you mean, of course, the life-size replicas.
By life-size replicas, you mean, of course, the petrified Asposians.
Laura, if Steve doesn't want to have anything to do with reality, that's his choice.
Thank you! Wait!
Their noses... They are all like you. We're like you. I'm sorry, Flute... Sorry, Robert.
It's okay. I didn't know them. At least, I don't think I do.
Yeah, these are all my people. Look at that one. Actually, look at a bunch of them. Like, that one's got like a... it's a saxophone, isn't it? For a nose? That is awesome. Might kind of get in the way, though, but still, pretty freaking awesome. Yeah, that one's got another one, too. I guess there's all sorts of types, right? Like flute noses and horn noses and saxophone noses. I'm guessing they were a very musical people. What happened here? We have this, like, gallery filled with them. It looks like they were all performing when they were petrified, and there's one standing out.
An empty water basin. I can't do anything with that.
Before I continue, I will be right back. Okay, let's take a look around.
The legendary Fourth Wind Fountain. It's just as dried out as all the others.
Yeah.
A stone Asposian. Hey, he has the same nose that I have. And the same eyes. I wonder who he was.
Maybe your father?
No, he's already broken enough. If I touch him, he'll fall apart. All these petrified Asposians have the same nose I have. I wonder what that means. But I have the feeling that the answer would only make everything worse. I don't know what I'm supposed to do with that.
It looks like there's some crystals up here. I wonder what they do.
Beautiful crystals. It'd be a shame if something were to happen to them. I can't use that.
Yeah, I can't think of anything to do with them. And even if I wanted to do something with them, I couldn't get them. I have nothing that can reach.
Strange thing. Is that what Laura's father meant? It almost looks like the sketch in the reception hall.
I think so, yeah. Oh, we have quite a puzzle here. A bunch of phosphoses.
Somebody carved something in it, but it's barely readable. Somebody... I can't use that.
Alright, so I need to make it more readable or something. Let's play, for the heck of it.
Quiet!
Well, it seemed to work.
Stop it!
Somebody carved...
It did something.
Stop it!
Oh my
god!
Quit your complaining, oh my god. I don't think I'm meant to do this now, but I'm gonna keep trying. Dear God!
Stop it!
Okay, it changed.
Stop it!
Alright, stop, yeah. It didn't lock up, did it? Hello? Game? No! Please tell me it didn't lock up. Yeah, it locked up. It did the same thing it did before. Last time it froze in the loading screen, where it's just stuck here. And you can see the loading screen and the music continues to play. And if you press escape, it stops the music as if the menu is actually coming up, even though you can't see it, like this. I'm gonna open the menu. And close it. Open and close. Weird. Okay, so I'll be right back. Okay, and we're back. Alright, so what else can I do, though? I mean, I need to get him out of here. Before I can do anything serious with this. And to do that, I need to polish the mirror, and to do that, I need to... what? Let's throw some mushrooms inside of the water basin.
Why should I do that?
No reason at all.
Hey, Laura. What did your father mean with that drawing in the lobby?
I don't know. Doesn't look like one of his inventions.
But what did he want to tell us with it?
If I knew, we wouldn't be standing around here like idiots.
Alright, I guess let's leave.
You want to go back? Follow me.
We know the way.
That's not the point.
Laura, he doesn't want us to walk around by ourselves.
Okay, my gosh. Steve, just so you don't feel completely useless, please escort us out.
Very well. Follow me.
Okay, I still need a hint. To polish the mirror. So, let's do that. Remember the entire song? I can find something behind Steve's counter, yeah, but how do I get him out? Neil lured Steve away from reception once more. After that, Laura could distract him. But she can't handle his flood of words. She can't handle his flood of words. Okay, got it. Earplugs.
Do you have any questions?
Can you show?
What?
Yeah.
Here you go, Laura.
Take these as earplugs. Maybe they help with Steve's blabbering.
It's worth a try. Wish me luck.
Good luck. Can you still hear?
What did you say?
Wow, your voice is beautiful when you scream like that.
I'm ready. You can yak away now.
So, the history of the cookie is one full of misunderstandings. Cookies, blah, 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 soft, blah, 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 blah.
Uh-huh. Interesting. Yes. Tell me more.
Oh, thank God, I don't have to actually hear him. Okay, that leaves me free to do whatever I want. You know what? You are supposed to make offerings, right? Down the wind tunnels? Maybe the cookies are an offering that I need to make? For something? I don't know.
Fire beetles. There were a lot of... Fire beetle. Conroy's... You have to say something to them to get them to heat up.
Didn't actually mean to skip that last part. Okay, do I want to heat them up? Magic word? What's the magic word?
Maybe there's a word that activates them. Let's try password one. Wake up. Avada Kedavra. You're supposed to burn. This isn't working.
You know what? I think I might know what to do, but also I just love the fact... The writing is so good. I love the fact that the first thing you mentioned was password one, right? Like someone who has an incredibly stupid or default password. That's just brilliant. Okay, I think I know what to do. Let's try baking, though. Let's see if baking works. Please, beetles, please.
Hey, you sweet little fire beetles. Would you mind, if it isn't too much trouble, could you please heat up? Is that a yes? I don't think that did much.
Okay, I noticed that the sound they make is very similar to another sound I've heard before. Which one do you ask? The one from the Conroy puppet.
What? Nothing to say.
And it didn't work. I don't know, they both made like beetly weird noises.
What? Nothing to say.
Maybe I need to use it on it? I don't think that's a solution now that I've just done it though, but let's try.
I can't do that.
Okay. Let's just look around.
An empty cold oven. What should I bake?
I'm thinking cookies. I'm not certain, but I'm pretty sure I'm going to be baking cookies.
The interior of the case is in the shape of the key.
Okay, I have a key case. What the heck am I going to do with that? Mixing bowl, grater...
A grater? You can grate things with it.
Indeed. Indeed.
These are baking ingredients. Unfortunately, all used up.
Of course.
I'm afraid they're all gone. How do you get the fire beetles to glow? Insult them until the correct temperature is reached. It's recommended that beginners avoid harsh swearing. No liability for consequential damage.
Okay, so if you insult them too much, they might, like, turn into lava or something?
I can't use that.
Okay. Why would I even want to heat up the oven, though? There's no reason to do that yet, right? Yeah, what the heck, let's do it anyway.
Fire beetles, Conroy said I could have one as a pet, but I always burned myself. You have to say something.
Insult. You stupid beetles, your mother was a dragonfly, yeah.
How am I supposed to insult beetles? Wait, what would Conroy say? You unworthy worm, you're a disgrace to all apprentices. That's why your parents dumped you on me. That's the reason why nobody loves you or ever will. Wow, it really works. But maybe I should put something in the oven. How do I get them to cool down again? Oh yeah, compliments. Hey guys, it's so cool that you have 6 legs. I only have 2.
That's adorable. They heat up when you piss them off, and they cool down when you compliment them. I just love this game world. It's amazing. Alright, so what do I need? Let me try this.
That's just a random guess.
No, it wasn't. Wait a minute. Could I use the grater to clean off the rust? I don't think that would work, but...
The interior of the case is shaped like a key. Recipe for soft cookie. A handful of sugar, 1/2 cup of nectarine juice, 1 kilo of flour, and a portion of chocolate flakes.
Okay, I have practically none of that, so that's going to be a problem. Well, there's the first one. Wait, did I actually put that in there? Because I still have them.
There's not tureen juice in it. It still needs flour, sugar, and chocolate flakes.
Right, again, I have none of that, so... Where am I going to find that? There's nothing up in the ingredients, right?
I'm afraid they're all gone.
What can I grate?
A phosphos. It's floating peacefully. I better put the case back. He'll probably panic if he notices that it's gone.
Okay, so I need the case for this room only. Why?
Butter cookies, of course, were invented in 1412 by the man from the very back of the kitchen, and he was looking for some margarine cookies, but eventually he only had...
Okay, fascinating. Right, so let's see if this works. I don't think it will.
Hey, don't scrub the ruins!
Oh, I'm sorry. Won't happen again.
Wait, does that mean I need him to go back and then I do it? Or... Don't scrub the ruins, so it was going to work? Okay, can I get him to go back?
Laura's distracting him at the moment. Why should I bother them now?
Laura!
Thanks, Laura. That's enough.
Thank you, Steve. That was really very uninteresting.
Okay, let's head on back.
Ah! You want to go back?
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. And let's go back out. On our own. And let's scrub that shield.
That didn't work out.
Seriously? Okay, hint. Give me a hint, please. Something to remove the rust. It's not strong enough. You need something more corrosive to dissolve the rust. Okay, well, I mean, there's, what's her name? Gorfalina? But, what could I possibly put her corrosive secretions in? I can't take it with me, can I?
I can't take it with me. It's too rusted.
I can't, pry it off?
Should I roll them?
No. How am I going to get her secretions? Take a look around, see if you can find something corrosive. You can find something near the gate. Yeah, like Orphelina, I know. But how am I going to get her secretions? I know. Use the grater with Orphelina. Wait, what? But wouldn't that just corrode the... I guess metal is... Okay, I mean, I guess... I assumed it was corrosive enough that it would just, like, melt the grater, but apparently it's not quite that corrosive? Apparently it's a very specific corrosiveness that the game never established with me, so I had no way to know. But, okay.
Thanks for scratching my belly, baby.
I suppose this grater won't ever grate again.
Nope. Yeah, it looks like it's already falling apart, but apparently it's okay. I guess she has very tough skin. Because on a human, using a grater on their skin would, not be pleasant, let's just say. I've accidentally used a grater when I'm cutting cheese on my hand. That wasn't pleasant. Don't you love it when your hand slips? Ugh.
Wow, impressive.
Alright, well, nothing about that made any sense at all, but okay.
My head tells me inedible, but my heart says chocolate flakes.
It does actually look like chocolate flakes.
My head tells me.
Okay, so the cookies I'm making are supposed to be visually cookies, right? They're like cookie stand-ins. They're actually not meant to be edible, because obviously if you ate rust, you'd probably die. So why would I want to make things that look like cookies but aren't? Just as an offering? I'm still going with that it's an offering. Okay, let's see what happens here.
What?
Yep.
Take a look at the mirror, Steve. Peter? Or Pete?
What are you doing here? And who's watching the reception desk?
Okay.
I can't take Pete with me. He only exists in Steve's head.
No, seriously? I thought he was real.
Was the courtyard used for something different in the past?
As I've already mentioned, the...
people waited here for an audience. Old Petey always took care that they had a good drink to keep them warm, if you know what I mean.
An audience?
Yes, with Ocarina Augustus II.
Okay, so this was like a royal palace. Got it.
Do you remember the attack? Were you there when it happened?
It's all my fault. I should have never let him in.
Him? Who did he let in?
The door is decorated so nicely. Were the people who used to live here all rich?
Oh, yes. Rich. With knowledge. The smartest and most respectable amongst us were here every day. Well, except for one. I should never have let him in. Old Peter's never forgiven himself, not even to this day.
Is that door the only entrance to the Wind Chapel?
Yes, it's the only entrance, but not the only exit.
Maybe you can go through the wind funnel. I still really want to fall through one and see what's on the other end.
Do you remember the rest of the song now?
Yes. I think I have it. Wait.
Mm-hmm.
If only I could remember the ending.
It's better you don't. That song is forbidden.
Oh, shut up.
And the rest?
I have no idea. The acoustics are not that great in here anyway. Let's go to the Wind Chapel. I'll probably remember the rest there.
Sounds good. Let's go.
Can you sing that song again?
Oh, I don't know. Pete's got his knickers in a twist again.
Oh, please.
Yes, we want to hear the song.
Okay, okay.
Okay, I think I've got it.
If only if...
All right, let's go.
May I point out that the door is locked? Entry is only permissible with golden
glasses. I know. Hold on. Oh, wait, can I take the dust? Oh, flower.
Plaster sang freshly off the wall.
My eyes say stone dust, but my heart says flower. Is that everything I need? It might be. What about sugar?
You want to go back? Follow me.
Oh, crap. Well, I'm not going to be able to put anything in the bowl because now he's behind the desk. All right, what else do I need? Well, this is either flour or sugar.
Fine stone dust.
Okay, it's... Sugar is usually granular, unless it's powdered sugar or something, so this would probably be flour. So I still need sugar. Alright. Golden basses.
We would like...
Entrance, please. Alright. Why don't you go ahead and sing that song? Steve Pete? Actually, I'm just gonna call you Speet. Steve and Pete. Wait a minute, will he not sing? Oh, right. He needs a reflection. Crap.
An empty water basin. I can't do anything with that.
Hold on, what'd you say about nod tureens?
A bunch of nod tureens. You can tell that the juice is fresh if the surface is smooth like glass.
Smooth like glass? Does it reflect?
No, thank you.
Maybe I need to fill this with water and he would see his reflection in it? Or something, but how... How would I do that? Alright, well, let's go back. And let's get into the kitchen. Without him there, of course. So we're gonna use our handy earplug mushrooms. Oh god. Well, this is kind of really back and forth. I gotta go, give me a tour. Okay, earplugs.
Can you distract him again?
Well, with the earplugs, it should be fine.
Good luck.
I'm ready. You can yap away now.
Ah, cookies, of course! Yes, lovely. Some of the worst kind of cookies you can have, because they make your gums hurt, and I don't really like hard cookies, but we never know, do we? Because hard cookies are some people's favorite, yes?
Yes.
Yes, yes. Okay, let's go. Hard cookies make your gums hurt. I think you're eating them wrong, unless you're talking about cookies that are like hard as stone. Alright. I'm missing sugar, right?
There are rust flakes, stone dust, and nod tureen juice in it. If you squint your eyes, it looks like chocolate flakes, flour, and nod tureen juice. It still needs sugar.
Where am I going to find sugar? What if I, like, nod tureen juice. Is that sugary? I mean, it's already in there, so I guess it's not.
The poor nodterines didn't do anything to deserve this.
Okay, I won't smush the nodterines. Where the heck am I gonna find sugar? Or something that looks like sugar, I guess? Once again, I can take this, but why? I mean, I guess maybe I'll end up being able to bake a cookie in the shape of a key? But why would I want to do that? I have absolutely no reason to want to do that. Sugar. Sugar, sugar, sugar. Let's go back out here.
He'll probably panic if he notices that it's gone.
I don't think there's anything out here that could be sugar, is there?
Not possible.
No. Alright, I think it's time for another hint. Only Pete knows the song, Yep, three parts. Middle part of the song in the inner courtyard. Now you have to get Steve in the wind chapel and ask him about the song. You can book a tour into the wind chapel by giving Steve the golden pass at the reception. Already done. There's no mirror in the wind chapel yet in which Pete could appear. I know. Is there something near Steve that could be used as a mirror? Yes, the water basin, but there needs to be something in it. How could it be used as a mirror if it had water? Water surfaces are reflective. You can fill the water basin with some liquid. Yeah, but what? Do you have anything suitable in your inventory? No. Not even close. Try the bouquet of nodterines. Nodterines are filled with clear juice. Wait, what? Seriously? But I would need like a gallon. You'd need like a gallon of nodterine juice to fill that thing up enough. Otherwise, it'd just be a tiny puddle in the bottom. Okay. That does not make any sense.
Soft cookies, on the other hand.
Thanks, Laura.
Thank you.
Okay, let's go.
Can we go into the
guided tours? Thank you for your.
All right, let's go.
Ah!
I don't like it when the solutions to a puzzle don't make any sense. That makes no sense at all. Even if those were really liquidy flowers. Which they're obviously not, because I don't see them dripping goo everywhere. Even if they were, you would need like 1,000 to fill up that basin enough to actually form a significant reflection.
We would like to
do you.
Alright, let's see how this works. Okay.
What are you doing here? And who's watching the reception desk?
Why did you sing that song, Speet?
Well, do you remember the song again?
Yes. I think I got it. I remember the whole song.
Knock it off!
Oh, yes. That's it.
No! Shh! It's forbidden to sing that song anymore!
Oh, it's so beautiful.
It's forbidden to sing that song anymore. Okay, so it was a known song. Like, it was something that they sung here frequently, I'm guessing. Maybe even this whole group of flute-nosed people. Although they're not all flute-nosed, some of them have other instruments for noses, but you know, the whole instrumentally-nosed people, maybe they were based around music as how they did something? Maybe that was their offering to the wind gods or something? I don't know. Seems kind of like it, but anyway, there's my sugar. Crystal shards! Wow, so I'm gonna have cookies made out of plaster dust, rust shavings, crystal shards, and some nautrine juice. I certainly hope no one is going to eat these cookies, because they would kill you. Okay, well, I still don't know why I'm making cookies, but I'm about to. Let's go. Now we gotta go back to here, and then we gotta do this. And we gotta do this.
Can you Can you distract him again?
Well, with the earplugs, it should be fine.
Good luck.
I'm ready. You can yap away now.
I couldn't skip that first part of the dialogue for some reason.
All the ingredients are in there.
Alright, let's crank this baby up.
The dough is ready.
Okay. Now, what am I putting it in? Am I seriously going to make a key-shaped cookie? I guess I am. Okay. Looks delicious. Looks like, pain and misery. And rust poisoning. I don't even think that's a thing, but, you know. Whatever eating rust would do to you, which would not be good.
Something's in the oven.
Yep, it's a something. It's not a cookie.
Fire beetles. Conway, you have... How am I supposed... You... That... The key should be done by now. How do I get them to cool down again? Oh yeah, compliments. Hey, Beatles, what's black and shiny and awesome? That's right, you are. Ouch, the oven is way too hot.
Do I need to use an oven mitt? Conroy's puppet? Are you gonna come in handy again?
Burn, Conroy.
Yep.
Oh, that's hot! Yeah.
Looks like the original and smells like cinnamon.
Cinnamon? Ugh.
And you go back in my pocket.
I love that the entire game is spent just messing with Conroy's puppet.
What? Nothing to say.
Now he's burned and he's covered in thorns. His puppet has taken so much abuse.
My own key to the wind chapel.
Okay, so now I can sing my own song in there without him being there. Although, honestly, I don't think it would be strong enough. Actually, no, it wouldn't. This is the recipe to make soft cookies. Attempting to use any cookie recipe, let alone a soft cookie recipe, to unlock a door would never work. It would just bend and then fall apart. But don't think about it. Doesn't make any sense. Doesn't matter.
Butter cookies, of course, were invented.
Thanks, Lord.
All right, let's go back. Okay, finally.
It really works.
All right.
I can't do anything with that.
Now I need to figure out what exactly to sing. Or not sing, but what exactly to play.